Yeah, I saw you on Twitter. You were tweeting from the Occupy Wall Street. You're down in the trenches. And one of the tweets that you posted, you said, Roseanne Barr, if corporations are people, then Goldman Sachs needs to be executed for premeditated mass murder, terrorism, mayhem, and grand larceny.
Yes, absolutely.
Would this be your platform then, running for president?
It's part of it is the part of my platform is, of course, that the guilty must be punished and that we can no longer, let our children see their guilty leaders getting away with murder because it teaches children that, they don't have to have any morals, and as long as they have guns and are bullies, that they'll win. And I don't think that's a good message. I do say that I am for the return of the guillotine, and that is for the worst of the guilty.
You're singing to the choir on this show. We've been advocating the guillotine for years now.
Oh, well, fantastic. We think alike in many ways. I first would allow the guilty bankers to pay, the ability to pay back anything over 100 million personal wealth, because I believe in a maximum wage of $100 million. And if they're unable to live on that amount, then they should, go to the re-education camps. And if that doesn't help, then be beheaded.
Now, we just recently saw the guillotine rolled out in a huge protest in Israel. 500,000 people in the streets. Basically, they are part of this global, what some call, or I call, the global insurrection against banker occupation. Has there been any communication between, let's say, the Tel Aviv, Wall Street, Athens, Cairo, Tunis? This is a global uprising. Do you see any of that
Yes.
global communication happening vis-a-vis Twitter and other sites, or just in any way?
Yes, I receive emails and messages and letters from all over the world, especially Israel and Turkey and even Iran, everywhere. I see it all, and I just encourage everybody, get together as fast as you can. Stop all that lefty factioning stuff that leftist men love to do. Women, come together. And it's ours, and we'll take it, and we'll fix it in a heartbeat.
All right, I want to now talk about solutions, because we started out the interview saying we would get into some possible solutions for Occupy Wall Street, and we promised people in the Occupy Wall Street that we would talk about some solutions. Now, let me put something out there, which is that the blood that makes the occupation of the banksters work, their stock and trade is their stock price. So therefore, in order to attack the banksters, one first has to accept that you need to decapitalize them, not decapitate them. That could come later. But initially, they need to be decapitalized. That is to say, drive their stock price down in some way.